When Dr. Uday Parikh and I conceptualized the integrated HRD system in Larsen and Toubro in the year 1974 and 75, we identified feedback and counseling as a subsystem within the integrated HRD system. The feedback that a senior gives to the juniors is based on the performance, the key performance areas, the behaviors that are exhibited, the attributes on which the person is to be assessed and so on. So every day, in and out, every employee spends a large part of his waking life for the organization and is performing various activities. A senior who has accountability to supervise, observe, and ensure good performance of his juniors has a lot of information to pass on. However, quite often, the way you pass on this information has rather negative impact than having a positive impact if you don't know how to pass it on. Therefore, we recognize it is important to train all executives in the art and science of feedback and counseling. Those days we called it counseling. Nowadays it is called as coaching. In fact, Uday Parikh and I sent an article on performance counseling to university associates sometime in early 80, and the university associates wrote back saying, we are modifying the title of your article as performance coaching. And they published this article in early 80s in the Structured Experiences, Pfeiffer and Jones Structured Experiences in Human Relations. So coaching is the term because it was felt counseling is used normally for people with issues and problems. I don't agree. In fact, the term to counsel means to help. However, many people feel comfortable with the term coaching and therefore you can put it. But the important part of performance coaching is feedback. All coaching is based on giving feedback and receiving feedback. It's a feedback from senior to junior and junior to senior and so on. So performance or the KRAs, key performance areas or tasks, activities, whatever term that you use, provide the context. So in an organizational context where most of us spend a large part of our waking life, it is very useful to once in a while sit with our senior and seek feedback. Why seniors? You can also sit with your colleagues and seek feedback, your juniors and seek feedback. But traditionally, if you say that it is the responsibility of the senior to identify, discuss with you your KRAs, observe you, your whatever your accomplishments or failures and so on, and keep discussing and giving feedback. Now, there is a lot of literature on the art and science of feedback. In fact, Uday Parikh has written at length on the principles of giving and receiving feedback. For example, a few principles are, I think feedback should be descriptive, not evaluative. Do not condemn a person. You only describe what you have observed. Feedback should be data-based. Feedback should be well-timed. Make sure that the other person is able to receive, is in a mood to receive feedback and so on. Similarly, I think feedback should indicate to the person that this is only what I have observed, but maybe I am biased. So you start with by acknowledging the limits of your feedback and so on. There are a whole lot of principles. If you want to make performance feedback effective, it should be discussed around feedback, around activities, around competencies identified. Nowadays, many companies have competency frameworks. So any feedback that you want to give for your juniors or from a junior to a senior, it will be useful to use the description of what is called as behavior indicators or levels at which a particular level of competency is to be exhibited and so on. So it becomes a little more meaningful. But remember, the feedback principles apply in the same way everywhere. If you are a genuine person, believes in human, genuine human resource development, you will believe that feedback is meant to help people to change. People can change at any part of their life and their career, irrespective of the age, sex, groups, etc., etc. If you start with this basic belief and open yourself and continue and willing to listen to the other person, the other person's point of view, and not insist your feedback is the only right way of doing things and so on, feedback will have phenomenal kind of an impact. This is what we call as performance feedback, and based on the feedback, you give performance coaching and so on. Please do refer to our articles on this. It's available in Designing HR Systems by Uday Parikh and T.V. Rao. It is also available at several places. Nowadays, there is so much of literature available on performance feedback. So friends, organizations are great opportunities for us to learn. KPIs, KRAs give a sense of direction. Competency framework give a sense of direction. When you use these frameworks for conversations, and these conversations are meant to improve each other, you are bound to use feedback. A feedback which is an empowering feedback, which is meant to build people, will always have its positive effect. Even at a point of time when you give the feedback, the other person appears defensive, soon the other person will realize and will start reflecting about it. Only thing is, don't insist when you give feedback to somebody, you are right, the other person is wrong. I think there is nothing like right or wrong. It only is contextual. The way you have observed, you have fed back, you have described, and leave enough of opportunity for the other person to decide how to act on it, how much to go by that, and how much to change, and so on. All the best from TVRLS, and I hope you are enjoying these short sessions on different forms of feedback.